Hi everyone, my name is Gedino Alberto and I'm an architect inside Spago BI Labs. Today I'm gonna show you how it's possible to use BI techniques in order to empower the business of a small company. And you know what? Actually, I'm very lucky to be in this position of the schedule for two reasons. Firstly, because I just coming after my colleague Davide, and this way I can complete the speech in order to fulfill totally the topic of this conference. So, from code to product to users, because of course a product should give a value to the users. Then it's also true that, you know, more or less, this is the time for an aperitif, at least in Italy. And so this fits totally with the topic, with my use case, so wine. We are now speaking about this company, that is the Pesci & Company, that was born, you know, after Second World War, and by, you know, a single man with a vision, so Carl Pesci. And he founded this company after the Second World War, and you know, in the first 50 years of activity, this company grew pretty a lot. So now it has more or less 60 hectares of different cultures of grapes, and around 20 employees. Everything was doing very, very good till 2010, where you know, the business started to slow a little bit, not too much. But, you know, in a moment where, for wine, the market was really, really going very good, you know, also as something starts to go slow, is not, you know, if all the market is going good and you start to go slow, there is some problem. And also the fact that Carl started to, you know, renew the bottling plants, and so this caused some financial problems. In order to reverse the trend, Carl decided to hire a consultant. The consultant was pretty famous because he already applied successfully BI techniques, like BI techniques based on new technologies and on big data. He's working with an IT guy that has also some knowledge about data mining techniques. The plan of the consultant actually is very simple. You know, cost reduction, work on marketing campaign, and renew the brand. The first act of the consultant is to understand how the company is placed inside the market. So he start to take the information about the sales of the company, and he start to compare this information with the information of the competitors and of the markets. It can do that, taking, for instance, information for the statistical association in Italy, open data about markets and about competitors. Merging all this information, he understood that it's true that in the last 5 years, the market of wine was really growing a lot, especially in Italy, but also the number of competitors was increasing. And also that the most successful companies are the ones that has a business outside of Italy. Then it's time to understand for the customer to know the company. So he collect all the data of the company coming from the different tools of the company, and he creates a classical data warehouse. This data warehouse is composed by three data marts, one for farmland, another one for sales, and another one for warehouses. Now it takes each of these fields in order to analyze and see if there is some margin for improvement. Starting from the farmland, we start to concentrate on the ratio between cost and production to create analysis on the geography of weather and the plant's diseases. What came out from those analyses are two points of interest. One of them is that, you know, when you have a not huge company, it's normal that you don't treat all the fields by yourself. In this case, the company treats 10% of the fields, and the other 90% is managed by external company. And it's also normal that, you know, when you handle something your, of course you handle in a precise way, so you work a lot, and it's normal that the production of the fields managed by you is better than the one managed by third party company. But here the gap is really too big, okay? Another insight is about hailstorms. You know, hailstorm is a big problem, especially in north of Italy. And so it's the company here is starting to work with HealthNet, you know, the net over the fields. And this is something not very good because there is a good amount of money that the company has to spend at the beginning and also for maintenance. So considering these two solutions, the consultant create a what-if analysis in order to see what is the impact of these two solutions on the business. And it can get that after 3 years, using these two solutions, we can get 9% more production of the fields and around 30% in 5 years. You know, there is the starting gap because at the beginning you have to spend money to create, to buy machinery and to form the workers. Now let's move to the second field, so marketing. The consultant decides to take the keywords around our company, so the name of the company, the Italian wine general, Prosecco, and something like this, and to see what are the sentiments around these topics in the socials. What came out is, you know, the Italian wine, of course, is very appreciated outside, in all the world, actually, especially in United States, in UK, in Canada, also in Russia, and also in the rest of Europe, actually. But what is more interesting is what he understood from the study of hashtag and topics. So, something like, there are some countries, for instance, UK, where the preferred place where to go to buy wine are the shops, the big distribution shops. Or that there start to be some interest from the customers on organic. So, you know, we started with information that more or less already know, like the markets for wine, United States, UK, and Russia, but some information that was not so clear and that we got from the analysis. Consider that those analyses are not fake, they are true. If you don't know Spago BI and you write those topics, those are what the information you can get. Don't use them because they are already sold to another company. So we have already something about organic and distribution in UK. Another interesting point is about Prosecco. You know, Prosecco, it's one of the most important wine in north of Italy. And also here we know that we have a good customers in United States and UK. But also in this case, we can understand something more analyzing topic and the hashtags. For instance, in this case, we know that the most searched topic is about Prosecco gift sets. And then that Prosecco, actually outside of Italy, is a wine that is very much appreciated for female customers. So, from this social analysis, we can get some very important information, some very important suggestion for the company. Something like, start creating gift set for Prosecco, something like special packaging, for instance, for celebrations, or packaging with bottle, with glasses, or something like this. And also to create a new line for packaging, for instance, for female customers, and also a line for organic products. Then, so we saw what happened with production, how we can get new customers, and now let's see how we can get more from the customer that we already have. So, you know, using data mining techniques, what we can do, we can create something like clusters of customers. So divide customers on sets. Now, suppose you have a cluster, so a set of customers, and we know that with, of course, several, you know, with some different characteristics in common, okay? So we know that with for a good amount of these customers, there is some product that there are a good amount of customers that like some product, or some product is very successful with some customers. There is a good possibility that the same product is good also for the other customers inside the same cluster, since more or less they have the same behavior. Okay? So in this way, we can do advertising, and so we can propose new products for the customer that we already have. Now here you can see some other results, okay, some other maybe little results about using these BI techniques, something like, you know, giving to the administration the possibility to monitor the warehouse with alarms, or maybe to create a weekly mail for the employee of the company in order to make them participate about the success of, about the company, or the possibility to monitor the impact of the promotion, or create a newsletter focused on the for a big and big customer, actually focused on their behavior in order also to propose those, in this case, new products. So you see that with all this measure, in a couple of years we can reverse the trend of the company and also the humor of our manager, of our Carl. So you saw that example was pretty simple. We saw different techniques, but I wanted to stress three points. First of all, we can use BI techniques also. We can use BI technique also for small companies. So BI is not just for big company, but can be useful also for small or medium companies. Then that consultant took different open source technology. So doing open source, we are not just creating business. We are also creating possibility for other companies to take and to build their stack and also to have, you know, to create their business. Okay. Here, just to conclude, we have just a list of you. So those are just some topic that we had, that the topic we discussed in this presentation. I just want to say thank to Monica. She's the leader of Big Data Architecture Engineering, and she also, in 10 minutes, drew the comics you saw in our presentations. Thanks.